This conference will now be recorded.
Vande vanchita labhaya karma kim tanna kathyate kim dampati miti bruyam utaho dampati iti. We just saw the Mangala Shlokam last week, I mean yesterday. One minute, let me just put this up and then it'll be easier for me. Okay. Now we'll go on to the next shlokam. So in the first Mangala Shlokam, he said, Vande Vanchita Labhaya Karma Kim Tanna Kathyate. So I don't know who is the object of my salutation. So he has a genuine doubt here. Don't think that it is Kaku. There is one aspect in Kavya which is called Kaku. So the idea is to sarcastically say, do I have to tell them as Dampati or Dampati? That is not what he's trying to say. He's actually in a genuine confusion here because he doesn't want to make a grammatical mistake. And at the same time, he understands that the form in front of him is only one person. Right? Shariram is only one, right? Here, what he sees. So that's why he has this doubt. Now, whatever it is, he has to say that his Ishta Devata is Shiva and he has to pray to Shiva for Mangala, right? And the Grantha Samapti. See, why do we do Mangala? So that your book is completed, whatever you are writing, the Kavyam or the task that you have undertaken finishes completely without any break in the middle, without any obstacle. Right? So that is the aim of a Mangala, and at the same time, you also write it down in a book, Shishya Shikshaye. Mangalam Granthe Nibadhnati. So the thing is, you can say Mangalam in your mind, you can pray to the Lord before you start a text, and you can start off. But Shishya Shikshaye Granthe Nibadhnati, that is a point that many people stress, especially. In order to say who the karma, who the object of his prarthana is, he goes to the next shloka. Drishtva kaustubham apsaro ganamapi prakrantavada mithaha girvana kativana santi bhuvane bhara divah kevalam nishkrante garale drute suragane nischeshtite vishtape mabhaishta. Iti gira avirasa dhuri yaha devaha tamevas tumaha. Drishtva kaustubam apsaro ganam api prakrantavadaha mitaha. So the idea here is he wants to put forth the object of his prarthana as the nayaka of his kavyam. So he has to talk about why he has chosen him as the Nayaka also. That is a very beautiful way of putting him on a stage, right? You're showing to people that this is why I have chosen him as the Nayaka of my Kavya. What is the scene? I think I mentioned last class. See, Drishtva Kaustubham Apsaraganamapi Prakrantavadaha Girvanaha Mitaha Prakrantavadaha. This Devas, Girvanaha are Devas. The Devas have started an argument. So the moment that Samudra Mathanam happens, when the churning of the ocean is happening, a lot of things come out. You have Kaustubamani, you have Airavata, Uccheshravas, Apsarastri, Lakshmi. There are so many items that came out of that ocean, right? So Kaustubham Apsaroganam, I think he also remarks that even Vishnu was in that fighting gang, right? So Kaustubham Apsaroganam api Drishtva, after seeing that, upon seeing the Kaustubhamani and the celestial damsels, Devaha, I mean Girvanaha Mithaha Prakrantavadaha Babhuva. So Mithaha, amongst themselves, they started an argument. So prakranta vadaha, prakranta means prarabdha vadaha. So they started arguing with themselves. What is that vadam that they had? I want this, you want that. Okay, let's just split. Right? It's like how, you know, siblings, when you give them a box of chocolate, the mo and if it is the same variety of chocolate, there is no problem. If each one is in a different shape, the moment they see it, the person who is, you know, very forceful, he'll say, I want that chocolate. You know, I want this chocolate. So that is how the devas were all fighting for the items that came out of the ocean. So Kaustubham Apsaraganam Apsaro Ganamapi Drishtva Mitaha Prakrantavadaha Girvanaha. So what are they essentially? Divaha kevalam bharaha. There is no use because of them. Because when there is a problem, they either rush to Vishnu or Shiva. They cannot solve any issue by themselves. Right? Any problem, they will immediately go to, first they will go to Brahma, and then from there they will go to Vishnu and then Shiva. Right? So divaha of the swargasya kevalam bharabhutaha. Bhuvane kativa nasanti. Such devas, how many devas we have in this world like this, who are just only a burden to the world because they keep on arguing about all these things. Even in this world, we say, you know, you should not have an argument over positions. That is what it is, essentially. What came out of the oceans were only positions that they wanted to have, right? They did not have the, that is why they were not Parameshwara. See, that is the distinction that he makes between the devas and Shiva. At that moment, when they were all fighting like this, Nishkrante garale, the garalam visham, visham nishkrante bahiragate sati. When that poison came out, what happened? Suragane drute. The entire host of devas which were fighting for the objects that came out of the ocean, the moment the visham came out, suragane drute dhavite sati. They all ran off. And at that moment, what happened was nobody knew what to do. So the entire world just stopped. In Tamil, we say, stambichu. So nischeshtite vishtape. Stambha, like stambhaiva tishte sati. So nischeshtite vishtape, the entire world, the universe was just standing still without any chesta spanda, not even one, because they didn't know how to act, what to do about it. The effect of the poison was such that it was blinding, they couldn't move, they couldn't do anything about it. At that point of time, dhuri, see, dhuhu, the literal meaning is actually I think it's the yoke or. Right? It's the yoke that you tie to a cow, and that is the dhuhu. Here, dhuri, so lakshana is where the main meaning of the word is negated, and you look for another meaning for it. See, here, you can't say that Shiva came and stood at the yoke, right? So here you say it is the forefront. You translate it as forefront. So agre. Dhuri yaha devaha dhuri ma bhaishta iti gira avirasa tammeva stumaha. So that is his main idea. Now I will only stumaha. I will only do stotram. I will only offer salutations to that Lord who stood at the forefront of such people when they were all running away and said ma bhaishta. Ma bhaishta means don't worry. Don't be afraid. Do not fear, I'm here. Iti gira, along with these words, avirasa, he appeared in front, appeared in the forefront of that scene. Right? So avirasa, sometimes these words like avihi and all will, avirbabhuva, avirasa, these join with asa dhatu or bhu dhatu to make the lit form. They cannot form on their own. So drishtva kaustubam apsaraganamapi apsaroganamapi prakranta mitaha prakrantavadaha divaha kevalam bharaha girvanaha bhuvane kativana santi. There are so many of these devas who fight for positions. Whereas when there is a problem, when a problem arises, these people who were fighting just run away. They don't want to address that problem or they don't want to take responsibility of that problem. So garale nishkrante sati Suragane drute sati, vishtabe nishchestite sati. When the entire world is completely without any actions and the world stops moving. Yaha devaha dhuri ma bhaisht iti gira saha. See, that is a very important gira comes with in third case. And you say usually a person just comes and then the voice comes. Whereas the moment he appears by saying the same words, ma bhaisht. See, if someone just appears in front of you, the first thing is fear. We don't say I'm happy. Even if it is a surprise, the first thing is one spark of fear that comes in everybody's mind. So when he arrives with the words ma bhaishta, it's so reassuring. So I want to only bow to that Lord. This shloka is actually where he establishes that karma, whom he wants to pray, to whom the stotra is. Right? Ma bhaishta iti. So purva shlokasya karma rupataya parameshwaram stauti atra. I just wanted to point out in this text that we are using, right, in the link that I had given, there is a vyakhyanam which you can use for your pratipadartha and everything. I just wanted to show you how to read it and just highlighted a few things so that for the next other shlokas it will be easier, and I want you to make an effort to look at it, and if there is a problem you can come back to me. Okay, so this is how the text is. If you look at it, the ones in the dark are actually, oh, why did it go there? 1 minute. So the ones in dark, if you have not studied a text as such, this will be very useful just for to note. You will find that in the top it is shloka 3, which is the next shloka, but actually the vyakhyanam comes underneath that. Okay, so you will have to look for the ones in bold. We are so lucky that this vyakhyanam, they have made some punctuation marks and everything. Most commentaries do not have all these extra embellishments and all that. So the ones in the dark actually is the word from the shloka, from the starting of the shloka, drishtva, right? And then he goes on to explain kaustubam ratnam apsaroganam devaganika nikarancha drishtva mithaha parasparam. So it will be useful for you to go on. When he says prakranta vadaha, he also describes why they have and how was the sort of the vadam that they started. Mama idam, mama iyam, ityadi vivadaha. Yaihi, taihi. This is all samasa is given in this form. Right? You can look at it. So the main part is this is how you find out. Then nishkrante garale ityadina. If you find another, the bold words like this, then you have to look at why he has given a bold font for this. Because it would have started with it's called avantara sangati. No? From one shloka to another shloka, when you go, there is always something called an avantara sangati. There is a connection. See, randomly the king, the poet doesn't pick out shlokas from like a magic hat. It's not, his brain is not like a magic hat where he just picks out shlokas and writes. It is a kavyam. There should be a connection between one and the other, whether it is from shloka to gadyam or gadyam to shloka. So that avantara sangati, that is called avantara sangati. Sangati is the joining. What is the connection between one and the other? That will usually be in the sentence before the thing that starts the bold. Right? For example, here you will find vandana karmatvena abhipretasya shivasya sarvottamatvam pratipadayati. That is not there in the shloka. Right? He wants to use, Shiva is the object of his vandana karma, and that is why he also, why does he choose Shiva? Sarvottamattvam. And that is why he chose him as the object of the namaskriya. Right? So just to point that out, I took from the shloka. Drishtva kaustubham apsaroganamapi prakrantavada mitaha girvana kativana santi bhuvane bhara divah kevalam nishkrante garale drute suragane nischeshtite vishtape माभैष्ट इति गिरा आविरास धुरि यो देवस्तमेवस्तुमः. Every time I read this ma bhaishta, I remember Subramanya Bhujangam, where he says ma bhai ritipo. The yamadutas and all will be standing at the last moment in my life, right? When you're about to die, the कृतांतस्य दूतेषु चंडेषु कोपात् कृतांतस्य दूताः, राइट? कृतांत इज यमा, यमास दूताः कृतांतस्य दूतेषु चंडेषु कोपात्, they're very angry and with दह चिंदि बिंदि इति माम तर्जयत्सु. They are constantly threatening me, दह, let's burn him. Do we have to burn him? Or do we have to cut him? That is how the Yama Dutal will be having a conversation there, right? Dahachindi vinditi mam darjayatsu. At that point of time, you have to come in front of me. Inna? What is the third line?
Mayuram samarukya mabhai ritikvam purashakti paane mamayahi shikram.
Aha, purashakti paane mamayahi shikram. Right? Mayuram samarukya, come fast. Don't just take your own sweet time and come in front of me. Okay, so mayuram samaruhya. You have to come really quickly at that point of time with your vahanam. Mayuram samaruhya ma bhairitittvam. Don't be afraid. See, that's why I said, every time someone comes in front of a bhayaprada, the first thing we say is, you know, because it's natural for anybody to feel that. No, that is a point of reassurance for people. So ma bhaishta iti gira avirasa dhuri yo devaha tamevas tumaha. Okay. The next shloka, as he, the moment you finish Guru Deva Namaskaram, you start off with Guru. More than Guru, it is, he says he's the person who established Shivadvaita and started the process of, you know, Apay Dikshita, in the shloka, he talks about Apay Dikshita and he says, Apay Dikshita Jayati, he is Srikantha Vidya Guru. He is the foremost of gurus as far as Shiva Vidya goes. Srikantha Vidya is Shiva Vidya. In this Kali, after many years, he was the person who came up and established the worship of Shiva in a very big manner, right? And he was also a scholar. He talks of Apaya Dikshita as an avatara of Shiva and Vishnu, both together in the shloka. Leedha leedha purana sukti shakala vashtambha sambhavana paryasta shruti setubihi katipayihi nite kalau sandratam Shrikantho avatatara yasya vapusha kalkyatmaneva achyutaha Shriman appayya dikshitaha sa jayati Shrikantha vidya guru. Guru namaskaram is the next one that you have to do. So he says, I mean, I'm a little bit confused with the way Nilakantra Dikshita is trying to say. I'm not sure whether he is saying Shiva has taken the avatara or it is Adi Shankara who has taken the avatara of Apay Dikshita. More likely Adi Shankara, but the Vyakhyanam is a little bit confusing here, so I just left it. Anyway, let us look at the words now. Main sentence here is Saha Shriman Appaya Dikshitaha Yasya Vapusha Kalkyatmana Vapusha Achyutaha Iva Shrikanthaha Avatatara Saha Shriman Appaya Dikshitaha Jayati Shrikantha Vidyaguruhu Jayati. At what time did Shankara take a birth? See, Adi Shankara had to prove something and he had to establish his Advaita Siddhanta. He came at a time when the Bauddha Mata was at its peak. Bauddha influence was very high in India and so both the it's not that it is bad. Buddhism has its own plus points like ahimsa or anything else, but they also have their minus points in the sense that one sect of Buddhism do not believe in Shruti, or the entire Buddhism does not believe in Shruti, Veda Pramanya. So any branch of study which does not give Pramanyam to Shruti or Veda, that is a problem, right? So Shankara had this difficult task of rallying people and to make them believe in Shruti, to regain the lost faith that these people had in Shruti or Veda. So the same way, Apedikshita, that so in the sense at that point of time, Apedikshita did not face Buddhism. Apedikshita only faced Vaishnavism and other branches which did not believe in Advaita as such. So he was also, in essence, he was like an avatara of Adi Shankara. So here the first two lines actually talk about Adi Shankara or Apedikshita. Let's see. So Lida Lida Purana Sukti Shakala Avashtambha Sambhavana Paryasta Shruti Setubihi Katipayehi Kalau Sandratam Nite Sati. So Shrikantaha Yasya Vapusha Avatatara. Shrikantaha is actually Neelakanta or Shiva. So here you can also talk of it as Shankara, which is Adi Shankara. So Shankara, who came, took a form, and he was in fact like Kalki Atmana Iva, when Yada Yada Hi Dharmasya Glanir Bhavati Bharata Abhyuddhanam Adharmasya Tadatmanam Srajamyaham. That is why Vishnu takes an avatara at every point of time. Whenever there is an adharma happening, whenever there is a loss of dharma, at that point of time, Vishnu takes an avatara. In Kali Yuga, it is the Kalki avatara. As if Achyuta, in his Kalki avatara, it is really Shankara is the avatara of Vishnu. It's so confusing. That's why I didn't know how to get it and describe. So he talks of Srimad Apayadikshita as an incarnation of Shiva in the form of Kalki and Vishnu to bring out the goodness in people, or to take out the people from the denseness that has been created. So what is this denseness that has been created? There is an Andhakara in the world that has been created by people who have not, who do not believe in Shruti. Right? So the Kali Yuga, Kalau Sandratam Nite Sati. Kalau, this Kali Yuga has been rendered completely Sandrana. Sandra is like being thick. Whereas you take it as Moha Andhakaram or Ajnana Andhakaram. That is Sandrata. This Kali Yuga has been rendered completely without any intelligence, or it is completely immersed in Ajnana at that point of time. By whom has it been reduced to this state? Katiprayehi, by some people who know only a very superficial knowledge, who have only a very superficial knowledge of the Shruti. Leedha Aleedha Purana Sukti Shakala. Purana Sukti Shakala means Amsha. They have very little knowledge of Purana and Sukti. I'll come back to that Leedha Aleedha. Avashtamba, because of this, they are extremely arrogant. So sambhavana paryasta shruti. So they think, they misinterpret the shruti. Paryasta shruti. Paryasta means they misinterpret the shrutis, the Vedas, which actually is like a setu. The shruti is a setu or a bridge between this bhumi and swarga. Bhumehe swargasya cha setu bhutam shruti. So sorry, I keep slipping into Tamil like this. Shruti acts as a setu between Bhumi and Swarga, because you do work, you do yaga, yajna and vrata, you follow a lifestyle in this Bhumi based on what Vedas say, and based on that you go to Swarga. That is your ultimate goal as far as Veda goes. That is the Karma Kanda. There is also a Jnana Kanda, right? The Jnanakanda talks about moksha, which is beyond this Swarga, which does not stop with Swarga. So Shruti essentially is a setu either for Ihamutrartha Palabhogam or it is also a setu for Aihikam and Moksha. For either the bhoga, the vishayas that you can enjoy in Swarga or in Moksha. So it serves as a bridge for everything. So Shruti Setu Bihi. But what do people do? Katipayehi, some people look at this Purana, Sukti, Shakala. They only look at a portion of it. Now, there are many people who just take out this verse, some verse from Manu Smriti and say, you know, Manu has said you have to beat women like cows. But the context, they miss out on the context. That is what is called Lidha. Lidha means you just, the literal meaning of Lidha is licking, Likha Dhatu. So you just lick the surface of the word, but it actually means sthula rupena, you try to know something, that's all. You're not trying to go deep into it. Right? So Alidha means that which has not been touched upon. So you can say anaswadita. The Lida actually implies that you are only looking at it from the surface. Alida means you do not know the sukshma aspects of the Shruti. Not only Shruti, but Purana, Sukti, Shakala, Avashtamba. They just read Sthula Rupataya, Kanichana Puranani, Patitani. So Alida na onakondi Sukshmataya Patitani. So what do? They read only the surface and grasp only some portion of the Vedavakyas. The outward import they understand, while the inner meaning remains unknown. But because of this, what happens? They are avashtamba. They're completely with the garvam. Okay. See, that sambhavana means they are very, they think that they know everything. And that is why, because of that sambhavana, they misinterpret paryasta shruti setubihi, the Vedavakyas. By these people, this Kali has been completely rendered unintelligent or ajnana. At that point of time, sandratam nite sati, Shri Kanthaha, Shiva, Achyutaha and Vishnu, or you can say Shankara, Adi Shankara, who is the avatara of Vishnu, who has taken the Kalki Atmana Iva, as if he is Kalki, right? As if he is in the form of Kalki. Yasya Vapusha Avatatara, who took the form, of Appaya Dikshita, I bow to that Appaya Dikshita. So Saha Shrikantha Vidya Guru, who has established the study of, not study, you can't say the Shivatantra. He is the guru for the Shivatantra. Shriman Appaya Dikshitaha Jayati. Jayati means Utkarshena Vartate, Sarvotkarshena Vartate Ityarthaha. You don't say that Jayati means he's victorious, he's ever victorious, not like that. Sarvotkarshena Vartate. He is Sarva Uttamaha, that is what it means, Jayati. Can you go to the next one or wait, let me see. Shrikantha Acharya Shaiva Guru. You mean there is a Shrikantha Acharya? Kamakshi, can you just unmute and say?
மத்வாச்சாரியார் மாதிரி இவரும் ஒருத்தர் இவருது இந்த சித்தார்த்தத்திலயும் அப்பய தீட்சிதர் எழுதியிருக்காருன்னு சொன்ன அந்த லெக்சர்ல
சைவ சித்தாந்த ஹி இஸ் ரிட்டன் அபவுட் சைவ சித்தாந்த தட் இஸ் கரெக்ட் பட் ஐ எம் நாட் ஷுவர் இஃப் ஸ்ரீகண்டா வித்யா குரு எஸ்ய சஹ இது அப்பய தீட்சிதான்னு சொல்றியா
இல்ல எனக்கு தெரியல
There is another person who is Shrikantha Acharya or enna solla vara enakku puriyala
adha inda innoru thara solrara Shrikantha Acharya rodiya maru amshama apedikshara solrara I know it's a little
see that is why enakku puriyala onnu vande Shrikantha angaradhu vande Shrikantha na alagana kaluthu So the one with the beautiful neck, which we talk about Shiva. Yeah. So it can mean Adi Shankara, because Adi Shankara came at a point when the Shruti was being misinterpreted by a lot of people. So he is Adi Shankara's avatarangra madri oru idu irukku. If you say Sri Kantha is a Vidya. அப்படி சொல்லிக்கிறாரான்னு எனக்கு தெரியல. வெதர் ஸ்ரீகண்ட வித்யா குரு ஹூ ஐ ஃபெல்ட் இட் வாஸ் தட் நீலகண்ட தீக்ஷிதா இஸ் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் அபய தீக்ஷிதா ஆஸ் ஹிஸ் சிவதந்திர குரு. அபய தீக்ஷிதா இஸ் ஹிஸ் ஓன் குரு அப்படிங்கிற மாதிரி சொல்றாரோன்னு நினைச்சேன். Or the, there, if there is another Shrikantacharya, you can say Shrikantacharya took an avatara as the form of, took an avatara of, as Abhay Dikshita, and he established, re-established the Shaiva Siddhanta. Enak, adhu correct solla therla. Whereas in the Vyakhyana, if you see, he just says Shrikantaha Kailasanayakaha. அச்சுதா நாராயணா கல்கி ஆத்மனா இவ கல்கி ஷரீரேண இவ பாஷண்ட உத்தாராய எஸ்ய வபுஷா அவததார. So he doesn't talk about ஸ்ரீகண்டாச்சாரியா. We can take it as that also. Okay. லீடா லீட புராண சூக்தி சகலாவஷ்டம்ப சம்பாவனா பர்யஸ்த ஸ்ருதி சேதுபிஹி கதிபயைஹி நீதே கலௌ சாந்த்ரதாம் ஸ்ரீகண்டோ அவததார யஸ்ய வபுஷா கல்க்யாத்மனா இவ அச்சுதா ஸ்ரீமான் அப்பய்ய தீக்ஷிதா ச ஜயதி ஸ்ரீகண்ட வித்யா குருஹ. தட் கல்க்யாத்மனா இவ ஐ ஹவ் நாட் மென்ஷன்ட் இட் இஸ் இது உத்ப்ரேக்ஷா இல்ல.
This conference will now be recorded.
Utpreksha alankara is sambhavana syat utpreksha. Sambhavana is poetic fancy where you are doubtful about what you are trying to say. In the sense, there is something that you are explaining, varnyam, and then there is upamanam or avarnyam, that is not the context. The context is you are talking of அப்பய தீக்ஷிதா கல்கி ஆத்மனா இவ ஆஸ் இஃப் அச்சுத விஷ்ணு ஹி டுக் த கல்கி அவதார இன் த ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் அப்பய தீக்ஷிதா. தட் இஸ் வாட் இஸ் ட்ரைங் டு சே ஹியர். அண்ட் வெரஸ் கல்கி டஸ் நாட் டேக் அன் அவதார அன்டில் 5000 இயர்ஸ் ஆஃப் கலியுகா ஹவ் பாஸ்ட் ஆர் சம்திங் லைக் தட். ஸோ சின்ஸ் இட் கெனாட் ஹேப்பன் ஹி இஸ் ஃபேன்சிங் தட் இட் இஸ் கல்கி. That is why it is called an alankara called utpreksha. Okay. Let's move on to the next one. Yat samrambhaha kriti rachane dushkavinam abhedyaha yachaikagrim tadupachita pada anveshane cittavrittehe labhyam tacchedapi kavayatam antatah trinyahani syadevam kim sarasa kavita rajya durbhiksha yogaha. So the Avantara Sangati, I was talking about it, right? So the moment he talked about the greatest poet in his mind, so Abhimatam Kavi Prastutya, his Ishta Kavi is Abhay Dikshita. So the moment he starts about them, as a contrast, he has to talk about the others, right? Just as how we saw in the second shloka, Drishtva Kaustubham Apsaragano, whereas Nishkrante Garale, he had to show the difference. You show the difference only to highlight someone. So at the same time, in the same manner, as soon as he talked about how Abhay Dikshita is Sakshat Adi Shankara, and he came up to only take people in the proper path, he had to talk about ku kavi ninda kutsitaha kavayaha katham bhavanti. So yats yas samrambhaha kriti rachane dushkavinam abhedyaha yachya ekagryam tad uchita pada anveshane chitta vrittihi labhyam tachet. See, there are many bad poets who are there. They make an effort to write, right? They make an extreme effort to continuously keep writing. instead of constantly writing and churning out, if they even spent one word, if they spent even 3 days to search for the appropriate words, uchita pada anveshane aikagriyam. See, there are two things that they should look at. So there are two things that they should concentrate on, which is they should write without stopping, one thing, and the other thing is uchita pada anveshane aikagriyam. They should keep on looking for the proper word to input in their kavyams, right, in their poem. So yaha dushkavinam kriti rachane abhedyaha samrambhaha yat cha chitta vrittehe tad uchita pada anveshane aikagriyam. See, if bad poets can get two things, which is abhedyaha samrambhaha kriti virachane. See, they cannot keep on writing. Okay, they keep on writing. A lot of people keep on churning out bad poetry every day. But does that work? Abhedyaha samrambhaha, they have that. Right? Abhedyaha, that which cannot be stopped, unstoppable. Samrambhaha, an effort. Kriti virachane, in writing. So in writing, an unstoppable effort is needed. You can't just write one shloka today and then stop for 2 months and then bring out another shloka. So yachcha chitta vrittehe, what is the other thing that is needed? Chitta vrittehe, the mind should have a concentration on searching which padam is appropriate at that point. You'll be reading auchitya vichara charcha. See, one word, if it has to be combined with another word in a shlokam, there should be an auchityam. It should be appropriate. Right? So tad uchita pada anveshane chitta vrittehe aikagriyam. In order to search for the appropriate words, you have to concentrate your mind in one place. So chitta vrittehe, chitta vritti are the thoughts that arise in the mind. At every point, you are trying to recognize objects in the world, and each object forms a thought in your mind, and that thought is called chitta vritti. Whether it is an object or a thought or an emotion, everything is represented in the form of chitta vritti. Chittam is mind, vritti is the in Tamil we say ottam, and the manadunudaiya ottam gramalyo, that is chitta vritti, the thought. Tad uchita pada anveshane chitta vrittehe aikagriyam. You have to also have the concentration of the mind in searching for appropriate words. Then what will happen? Tat antataha trini ahani kavayatam labhyam chet. If at the end of at least 3 days, trini ahani antataha kavayatam, kavayatam dushkavinam, the bad poets who are trying to make a poetry, kavayatam labhyam chet, if they are able to get 3 days. Why is he talking about this? Because this poetry, if you look at this poetry as a kingdom, it is undergoing a famine at this point of time. Nilakanta Dikshita says, see, for him, he looks around him and he only sees people continuously writing, but not writing with the appropriate words or anything. They're just randomly churning out poetry. Right? So kavayatam yadi trini ahani labhyam. If for 3 days they are able to get two things, what are the two things? One is this effort, and the other is to search for proper words, a concentration. If they can do these two things, then evam sarasa kavita rajya durbhiksha yogaha syatkim. Then would there be a famine in this world of poetry? That is, people can definitely write. It's true. If you continuously keep on thinking about words and trying to put in appropriate words, automatically you will be able to write. There is no question about it, I'm telling you. The more you write, the more you will be in that mode. All it needs is your mind has to be concentrated in that task. Evam sarasa kavita rajya. Sarasa kavita is a beautiful poetry. Poetry that has, I told you, right, vakyam rasatmakam kavyam. Kavyam is something which has rasam in it. So Sarasa Kavita, the poetry, delightful poetry, and that poetry is like a kingdom. If a kingdom has to flourish, then there should not be any famine in it. There should be a constant effort that should go on in the country to keep it so that people don't let it go into famine, right? And people should also be concentrated uchita pada anveshanam. That is, they should each one person who is in that appropriate position in a kingdom should also do his work with the aikagriyam. So that actually goes for both, for the kavita and the rajya. Didn't understand that before. Okay, tad uchita pada anveshane chitta vrittehe aikagriyam. So if each person can do what he likes, what he is passionate about, and he does that with the focus, at the same time, if efforts keep on happening in the country, then there will be no famine. That's what he says. He compares that to Sarasa Kavita. So the poetry is also has to be, it can be effective and delightful only if such a thing happens, right? So the Sarasa Kavita Rajyam, Sarasa Kavita Eva Rajyam, you're superimposing the kingdom on Kavita, and that's why there is Rupaka Alankara. The other Rupakam is actually a bit tricky. In the sense, he says, Sarasa Kavita Rajya Durbhiksha Yogaha. Right? Durbhiksha is famine. Famine cannot happen in Kavita. See, the whole world does not have any beautiful poetry at this point. Right? So the famine is something which is associated with crops or lack of water or anything of that sort. So here you take it as Sarasa Kavita Sampatti Abhavaha Durbhikshaha. So the wealth of beautiful poetry is absent. That is superimposed upon by Durbhiksha or famine. So superimposition or metaphor is the point of Rupaka. So you have both Rupakas here coexisting. So that's why it's Sankara Alankara. Siriyarka? Any doubt? Okay. Yes, samrambha kriti virachane dushkavinam abedyo yachaikagrim taduchita pada anveshane chittavrittehe labhyam tachedapi kavayatam antata strinyahani syadevam kim sarasa kavita rajya durbhiksha yogaha. And the idu purinchado strinyahani, I hope you understood that. Okay. Athava, do we have time? Okay. Athava kimiti smarami dushkavina adhuna. Dushkavina adhuna. That is part of the gadhyam. So sometimes the poet gives an avantara sangati, a connection between the earlier shloka and the next shloka in the form of a small line like this. Either he will say apicha or athava kimiti. He uses all these things to introduce either the shloka or the gadhya. So we can use that itself as the avantara sangati, or we can search for something. We have to look for something if it is not present. Okay. So athava, otherwise. So otherwise, what does he mean? Matantaram. Why should I look? Why should I be negative and talk about these bad poets? Let me not think about them. He justifies his point by saying, what is the use of thinking about these bad poets? So he justifies it with the next shloka. He says, sakala bhuvanaika mangala shankara guna varnana pravrittena na smaraniyaha kudhiyaha lokayatika iva vratastena. Lokayatika iva vratastena. A person who is performing penance, right, tapam, tapaha, or vratam, if he wants to pursue in that margam, he should not be thinking about lokayatika. Lokayatika are persons who are charvaka. That is, how do I say that? Hedonistic people, right? Hedonistic people are lokayatika. They just live for the moment. There is no afterworld, there is no punarjanma, there is no past janma, there is no papa punya. let me do whatever I want today and live the world today. A person who wants to proceed, who is in the Bhakti Marga or who is in the Karma Marga, should not think about such people. So na smaraniyaha kudhiyaha, these people have a kutsita dhihi eshampe kudhiyaha, they have a very bad intellect, right? Kutsita is not bad. Bad is such a generic term and does not explain as such. I would say nindyadhihi, it is fit to be scolded, right? Sarva bhuvanaika mangala shankara guna varnana pravrittena. My point here is, my idea here is, I have started to describe the different gunas, the different qualities that Shankara has, Shiva has. Now, who is this Shiva? Sakala bhuvana eka mangala shankaraha. Oh, I've only written alankaras here. Seriously? Okay. Sakala bhuvana eka mangala shankaraha. Shankaroti iti shankaraha. The very word Shankara has sham or mangalam in it. Right? What is mangalam? Mangalam is that which gives you, that is, you generally say, you translate it as auspicious thing. The thing that gives us the most auspicious thing in the world. Right? Or who is the most auspicious person? What is auspiciousness? That which gives you the ultimate prayojanam. See, you're in this world, continuously going through the cycle of birth and rebirth. The one that can get you out of this cycle should be the most auspicious thing, right? Because this cycle is something that it is not desired. You don't want to keep going through this. You want to get to an eternal state where from which there is no return. Every janma, you know, there is a death, maranam, and then there is another janma. Because you are constantly trying to balance, trying to get rid of the papa and punya karma. Right? If you want to get out of this non-ending cycle, you are looking for some position from where there is no return. And that position is moksha. That should be considered as the most auspicious thing. That is why we say Mangala Swarupi Shankaraha. Sham Karoti Matrala. He is of the form of auspiciousness. So he is Brahma Swarupa, in fact. So Sakala Bhuvana, for the entire world or the people in this entire world, Eka Mangala, he is the only auspicious thing, auspicious form, which is Shankara, Shiva. And Shankarasya Gunana Varnayitum Pravrittaha Asmi Aham Kavihi. So Shankara, I have started to describe the qualities of him. So Ananta Kalyana Guna, that's what they say in Vaishnava tradition. So Ananta Kalyana Guna Varnanam. When I have started to do that, Maya Kudhiyaha Na Smaraniyaha. I should not be thinking about all these Dushkavi. Right? Like how Vratasthena Kaschana Purushena, the one who is involved in doing a penance, he should not think about people who are Charvaka. If a person comes and talks to you, you know, what is the use of doing all this vratam? No, you know, I will get punyam, and when is that punyam going to act? Not today. Will it act tomorrow? You don't know. So there is an unknown thing there that is working for people. But if there is no point in talking to people who are questioning every little action of yours, right? So those peoples are lokayatika, and they live for the moment. So vratasthena lokayatikaha nasmaraniyaha yatha tatha maya api kudhiyaha nasmaraniyaha. That is upama alankara, because he compares himself with a vratasthaha and kudhiyaha with lokayatikaha. Okay, the parameshwara guna varnana pravrittena maya iti visheshya sabhipraye parikara alankara parikara ankuraha. Parikara ankura is an alankara where the visheshya or the person, see here he has not mentioned maya. The only word that indicates the poet is the visheshanam itself, right? So you call the, that is actually the Visheshya, that is the word that is being described, that talks about the poet, and it acts like a Visheshana. The word itself is used with a purpose. If that word itself is used as a purpose, with a purpose, and the Visheshya is not mentioned, then it is Parikara Ankura. Sariya irukko? Does that make sense? Okay.
Okay.
Huh? Yeah. Okay. That's, I was doubtful when I put this in. But anyway, Parameshwara Guna Sabhipraye, Visheshye Sabhipraye Parikara Ankura Alankaraha. The next one is also a very simple shloka. Generally, when people start off their kavyam, they do an Ishtadevata Namaskara, then the Guru Namaskara. Then they talk about the old kavis who have been there. Pura, what is that? Sutre Manigana Iva. There were many poets before me and they have talked about this. They have said this Ramayanam or Mahabharatam or anything. All I am trying to do is, you know, Kalidasa says in Raghuvamsha, Sutre Manigana Iva. They are all scattered in different places. All I am doing is just gathering them together in my poetry. So it's his way of paying homage to the earlier poets. Right? So that is a tradition that is followed in many kavyas. Even in Yadava Abhidhayam, you will find that I'm in fact ashamed to talk about this topic, he says, when he talks about Krishna's birth. He says, I'm ashamed to even talk about this because there have been so many great people who have talked about it and who have described it more beautifully than me. I don't know how I will be contributing to it. Here, he starts off in a similar fashion. But he does not say that. He says, Kati kavayaha, kati kritayaha, kati luptaha, kati charanti, kati shithilaha, tadapi pravartayati maam shankara paramya sankatha lobhaha. Even then, I want to see, there were so many kavis in before me, so many poetries, kritis and poems, kavyams that have been written before me. Many have even been lost. Many are still present. Many are in a very, very, shithilaha. They are in a very dilapidated condition, right? Kati kavayaha, there have been many kavi, like Kalidasa Adhyayaha, Kalidasa, Bhavabhuti, you have so many poets before, because he's after all 17th century, right? So kati kavayaha, even Kalidasa says, Puranam ityeva nasadhu sarvam nachapi kavyam navamityavadhyam. He starts off his poet by, Malavikagni Mitram, where he says, Purana Mithyeva Nasadhu Sarvam. So there have been poets even before Kalidasa, where he says, you cannot keep on talking about the olden people. You know, it's a very common thing, even in Carnatic music, if you see, you know, that old master's song and all is so good, these people cannot even stand near them. So that's a very common thing that they do. I mean, what is the new thing that this person has written? Why should he even write a kavyam like this? It's a very natural question that you ask. So Kati Kavayaha, there have been many poets, I agree. So they have also written many, each one, not the number of works are much more than the number of poets that were available, right? Because one person has written some hundred, in fact, Abhay Dikshita has written 108 works. That is his, that's what they say. I don't know how many people have actually counted it. So, kati kavayaha, kati kritayaha, kavibhyaha api adhikaha kritayaha, right? Kati luptaha, you don't know how many are lost. If you look at the Lalitasahasranama Bhashyam of Bhaskar Raya, Bhaskar Raya was quite recent only, not a very old person, in the sense 15th century itself is recent for us. Bhaskar Raya has written so many works like Tantram and Saubhagya Tantram. Maybe Saubhagya Tantram is available, but there are so many other Ashta Trimshottara Upanishad or something like that he has mentioned. There are so many works that he has mentioned are not available today for us to even look. Even in a manuscript form, they are not available. We don't know where he got those texts and he has written. So even within some 300-400 years, kati luptaha, There have been so many which are lost to us. Kati charanti. At this point of time, there are many people who are even writing now, and you can take it as that. Kati charanti. You can take it as people who are still writing, or the works that are still available, or kavayaha kati charanti. Or there are so many kavis amongst ourselves. If you are in some WhatsApp group, there will be someone who is posting their shloka every day in the morning. Right? So kati kavayaha, there are many poets who are roaming around among us. Kati shithilaha, there are many works which are only available half. Even Neelakanta Dikshita's Nala Natakam, Nala Charitam, only 5 acts are available and it ends halfway also. It doesn't end fully at the 5th act also. So when so many are there, tadapi, even then tathapi, mam shankara paramya sankatha lobhaha pravartayati. I have a greed to talk about Shankara's uttamatva. He is the greatest person. And that is why, not person, God, right? So Shankara paramya, paramya means paramasya bhavaha paramyam. Paramata, paramatvam, paramyam. Shankarasya paramyam. I want to talk about it in the form of a sankatha. In order to talk about it, I have a greed for that. So my that greed is prompting me to write about it. So kati kavayaha. Kati kavayaha, kati kritayaha, kati luptaha, kati charanti, kati shitilaha, tadapi pravartayati maam shankara paramya sankatha lobhaha. Even though there have been so many people who have written before, I want to talk about the love that I have for his paramya, this greatness. That love prompts me to write. Can't say greed, right? Lobhaha is more of an attachment towards talking about his greatness. If we go to the next one, it will take some time. So we'll stop with this. Let me know if you have any doubts. Actually, I just remembered the, in Raghuvamsa also, he says, when he says, Asamutra Kshitishanam Anakar Atavartmanam, he talks about why he starts off this Raghuvamsa. He says, Raghunam Anvayam Vakshye Tanuvak Vibaho Pisan Tadgunaih Karnam Agatya Chapalaya Prachoditaha. Very similar words. Okay? What does this Kavi say? He says, Tadapi Pravartayati Mam. It prompts me to say this, right? It's the same way he says, Tadgunaihi. In the Raghuvamsa, the kings of Raghuvamsa, their gunas, their qualities are so great that I have been prompted by a chapalaya, or chapalam dane, in order to write about it. So chapalaya prachoditaha, tadgunai karnam agatya chapalaya prachoditaha. Very similar way of expression that Neelakantha also has. Okay, stop with this. You have any doubt? Yes. Is that doubt to come up? I don't get what.
Just tell me thanks.
No.
In the second,
yeah, second shloka, avirasa,
gira virasa.
Gira virasa, you just split it as gira avirasa.
Gira
avirasa. Avirasa is one word. You're doubtful about the word avirasa or gira.
Understand the gira.
Okay, so gira along with the words. So with the words Ma Bhaishta, he appeared in front. Avir Babuva, you know, Avir Babuva means he appeared, right? So by saying, as soon as the moment he came in, he did not, he did not first come in and said, oh, there is a Visham or that or this. He did not talk about all that. He came in with the words. Gira means Gihi Girav Giraha. It is a Rakaranta. So Gira is with the words.
Oh.
Ma Bhaishta.
So he used those Ma Bhaishta. Those words, here they're saying Gira is the words that he.
He no ma bhaishta iti gira. Ma bhaishta are the words with which he appeared.
Iti gira avirasa.
Avirasa.
And in the first line, apsara api prakranta vada mitaha.
Mitaha ityukte parasparam.
Parasparam.
Mithaha.
There was one other thing that I said. I think I got. Listen to it.
Yeah, listen to it one more time and then let me know if you have any doubts. Okay, I can clear it. Your voice is getting cut. I don't know why.
Fine. I cannot see.
You cannot see the slide?
Yeah, I like your you sitting on the chair.
Now you can see the slide.
Yeah.
Usually you can see both, so I was wondering.